Hello, citizens of the world! Today we will be telling about the greatest thing to come out of Minnesota. No, not those board game type folks, but spam, as the 5th of July is National Spam Day. Born in 1937, the meat of many uses is made from pork with ham meat added, salt, water, modified potato starch, sugar, and sodium nitrate. It was catapulted to fame during World War II, where more than 68 million kilograms of spam were distributed to US soldiers, earning it the nickname Special Army Meat. It was also sent abroad to relieve many war-torn countries suffering under rationing, including the United Kingdom and the Soviet Union.
All right, you can stop stalling now, it's arrived!
Hello, investigators, and welcome to the overview video for In the Clutches of Chaos on this very special day. This is product number AHC34, which is pack number 5 and comprises scenario VII of the Circle Undone, which is the penultimate Mythos pack for this cycle. It comes in a blister pack, which is 1/2 spam tall by 1 spam wide and promises the ever-reliable 60 fixed cards. There is a QR code on the back which allows you to get a look at the cards before you open it up. Unlike spam, however, you don't need a key or a ring pull or even a can opener to unlock it. And there is your usual rule sheet tucked in under the flap. It is another double sheet. Inside, the cards are shrink-wrapped with your language sticker on the front, blue for English. They have the Guardian cards on one side, and we won't turn it over as there is a location card spoiler side out on the reverse. Every class gets 2 cards each, and there is even a neutral card. On the surface, things appear pretty normal. There is no new card type, no new slot, no weird skills, no hunch deck. Much as we feel overwhelmed at times by the amount of innovation in the Circle Undone cycle, it is not like they use the lazy school of game design by just making the numbers bigger. Oh dear. Why don't you enjoy a slideshow while we make some spamwiches? That is totally a real word.
If you think spam is just a sandwich meat, you're wrong. This special blend of pork shoulder with ham is also a great breakfast meat, and a great salad meat, a great casserole meat, a great cookout meat, a great pizza meat, a great snack meat, and of course, a great sandwich meat too. Spam, it's a lot of meats, but not a lot of money.
Spam, spam, spam. Hormel's new miracle meat in a can. Saves time, tastes fine. To eat something grand, ask for spam.
Welcome to this game's first and only 7 resource cost card. And at 5 XP, it probably won't be seen that often. You can still bring it out first turn if you devote 2 actions to gaining resources. But if you are at 0 because maybe you bought a weapon, then not even the 2 emergency caches will be able to fund it. With it costing 5 XP and 7 resources, you would expect it to be pretty snacky. And it is! This is so much more than just a Brother Xavier on steroids, although it doesn't give you the +1 willpower or departing kick. If you are considering playing a Guardian true solo, this is like having a whole other investigator along for the ride. You have a pop-up Agnes Baker to do 4 instances of pew-pew damage, and the equivalent of 4 working a hunch, all without dipping into the chaos bag once. This is expensive, but compare that to the cost of achieving these effects individually. And not just the cost, but the amount of card slots you would need in your deck as well. Take note, because it exhausts when used, you need to pace yourself. If you are playing a standalone scenario or a multiplayer special event, this card packs an amazing amount of punch. And don't forget, it is an ally, so you can heal it. If it wasn't level 5, it might have been the ideal Carolyn card. Is this a dynamite alternative? Well, you still need to make a fight test, so it's more like a Guardian Storm of Spirit, as you only get to use it at your location. Note how it says other investigator, so you are completely immune to its effects, unlike Dynamite Blast, and there are no attacks of opportunity, as it is a fight action. This is great if you love to play Taunt or Let Me Handle This and be in the thick of it, and it's perfect for solo play. Plus, you can target the weakest enemy like some rats and still do 2 damage to a hefty adversary, including elite ones. But what is that last line? Because it is a fight action, you can enhance the damage with things like the Viscous Blow or Marksmanship. But again, because it is a fight action, only the enemy you target gets increased damage. Everyone else takes 2 damage regardless. You can charge it up with contraband, but not extra ammunition, as it isn't firearm traded. And did you notice it doesn't take up a hand slot? Time to retire that bandolier. If you love to play this game and treat your character's journeys like a mini role-playing game, this highly thematic card is definitely for you. Likewise, if you are a truly cooperative player, this allows you to take one for the team. Most, but not all, Seekers are built for trauma. Just don't give it to the anti-Roland. But maybe give it to this guy, who has a bit of a reputation for self-sacrifice. Coupled with I'll see you in hell, this makes two classes who can fall on their swords and make the ultimate sacrifice. Oh, don't be silly. What's this? Another permanent? We haven't seen one of these since Threads of Fate. What is even better than card draw? Having already drawn the card. And having 20% more cards in your hand means you are 20% more likely to see the cards you want. Ah, what are we talking about? It'll always be at the bottom of your deck. The extra card is drawn before you get to Mulligan 2. And Studious means the Seeker's time with the Rogues for the most permanents by class. Oh wait, spoke too soon. Two extra resources on turn one are not to be sniffed at, especially if you have some engine building to do. Getting your stuff out as fast as possible before being subject to attacks of opportunity, particularly when playing solo, makes sense. And if you draw Indebted as your weakness, this is a great way to buy it off and still come out ahead. A mini-theme of The Circle Undone has been these favour service-traded cards for Rogues. All of them have different paired icons, so we might say fourth or a fifth card in this subset before long. And who doesn't love Tesla's damage? It's a Rogue staple, in fact. In this new format of flexible Rogue cards that can be played in one of three ways, this is the most variable damage card we have seen. Watch out for attacks of opportunity, though. It would seem a shame to waste it on some rats when you can go full-on sniper and get headshots all the way across Paris. Speaking of headshots all the way across Paris, yes, you can use marksmanship with grenades and lob them truly vast distances, yet while still blowing things up at your location. Returning to the subject of cards with options, we have the new bait and switch. Do you remember the idea of a true multi-use card? No? Haven't been playing that long then? This has a straight choice you initiate when playing the card, and despite being experienced, it has the same ability, albeit with slightly clarified wording, as the original, and a new quirky one, reminiscent of Think on Your Feet. Good for solo play and non-hunter enemies, or maybe for delivering a straggler to your guardian. And yes, you can fling that sugar off halfway across Paris, and yourself too! A lot faster than taking the metro. For anyone convinced Baseball Bat Wendy is actually a thing, here we have a card that can temporarily mitigate a low stat. Take note, Preston or Calvin. You only get to do it on your turn, so it's no use in the Mythos phase to save you from a nasty test. But when it is time to go all out on your investigating, fighting, evading, or willpowering, this is the card you have been waiting for. And note, it sets your base value to 5, so any bonuses will stack on top of this. Speaking of bonuses, remember how Deny Existence stopped the bad things happening to you? Well, the experienced version goes one better and gives you a positive effect instead, based on the opposite of what would happen to you. So, if you lost one action, you would gain one. Rather than discard cards from your hand, you would draw them into your hand. Be careful when you play this, as you don't want to draw out and take horror and be eliminated. Remember too, when healing damage or horror, you can't go above your maximum starting values. You can't gain extra health and sanity. So what happens if you meet an abstract term, such as lose all your resources or discard all your cards? Well, dust off that high school calculus, as you will need to do some maths. Simply work out the amount you would have lost and gain that amount instead. For example, if you were instructed to lose all your resources and you had 5 resources, you would gain 5 resources. You wouldn't gain all the resources, that's just silly. And our favourite hedge shrinker gets to take this, as it says it heals horror, even if she can't take the level 0 version. Would you look at that? It's a mystic ally, rarer than hen's teeth. This makes 5 mystic allies, barely half of the 8 that Seekers and Rogues have. As a free action, you can attach a single event spell to her, and play that spell as if it were in your hand. This is handy. Ah, get it? If you are facing a scenario that is very discard heavy, or for some reason your hand is clogging up and you keep going over your limit. It has to be a spell, so no rituals or the like. It has to be an event, so no shriveling or rite of seeking. But Storm of Spirits or Ward of Protection are great choices. Once that event is played, it doesn't go to the discard pile but hangs around in perpetuity and you get to keep playing it. Only once per turn, because she exhausts when doing so, and only as long as she has secrets remaining. Finally, a use for truth from fiction. Ah, not so much. Did you spot there is nothing about discarding Dana or her attachments once she runs out of secrets? So just push her in front of a passing Shoggoth. Although, with the most health of any mystic ally, it might take a few attempts. And once you choose a spell to attach, it can't be displaced by another one. It's not like a slot, you are stuck with it. But good news, you can play Uncage the Soul for a lovely discount, as a card attached to Dana is counted as being in your hand. Still costs you a secret though. Speaking of allies, oh my word, a neutral ally. Have any of you seen one of those before? We had to check, and the only other neutral ally is Horace, the red-gloved man. For anyone wanting more tarot action, we have here the next best thing, a human tarot card. Not only does she give you two whole extra tarot slots, meaning you can have three in play at once, that includes more than one of the same card, but she behaves like a tarot card herself. If she's in your opening hand when the game begins, you get to put her into play, just like a tarot card, and you don't have to pay her cost either. Plus, as a reaction to her coming into play, you get to search your deck for a tarot asset and put it into play. So you can use her to get three tarot cards into play before the game begins, right? Whoa there, young fella my lad. Remember, each reaction ability may be triggered only once each time the specified condition on an ability is met. She only comes into play once, you only get to trigger her reaction once and search your deck once. If you have tarot cards in your hand, however, that is a different story, as her constant ability takes effect right away. Wow, that was a lot of card. Let's go to a commercial break while we get our breath back.
There is only one Spam, and you can serve Spam so many different ways. Spam and eggs. Broiled cheese sandwich. Baked Spam with scalloped potatoes. Spam and cheese ribbon loaf. Cold or hot, Spam hips the spot. All quality canned meats by Hormel.
Does anyone else feel peckish now? No? Moving on. Today's scenario does seem to be heavily influenced by the board game. No, not just the fact it takes place in Arkham in the same locations and neighbourhoods, but like the board game, you'll be putting tokens on locations, and when you get three in the same spot, boom! Instead of calling them Doom and Anomalies, they have renamed them to Breaches and Incursions. Either way, this is the out mechanic from Pandemic that feels very jarring. This cut and paste is definitely not as creative as many of the previous scenarios, but as always, try it out for yourselves. That is the end of the Arkham Horror content, folks. Thanks for watching, and thanks very much if you feel like sharing this. It really does help us no end. Before we go, there is just time for a few more Spam facts. Did you know that more than 12 cans of Spam are eaten worldwide every second? And more than 8 billion have been sold in total. Hawaii loves Spam so much that they serve it in McDonald's and Burger King. We also want to say a massive thank you to Hormel Foods, who were incredibly helpful and generous in providing all their archive footage and advertising to us. Happy 82nd birthday, Spam! And if you find yourself in Minnesota, don't forget to check out the Spam Museum, where you can become a Spambassador.
Spam, 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 spam